as temperatures rise, and they will eventually, maple syrup season getting ready to kick into high gear here in Minnesota, and there are some tasty ways to enjoy this seasonal treat. James Beard nominee chef Beth Dooley is here to serve up a savory and sweet dish that you're definitely going to want to try. It's good to have you here today.
Oh, it's so fun to be here.
We don't have sunshine outside, but you brought it inside here.
I know.
What is with maple syrup? Because most of us do identify it with breakfast food and that kind of thing.
I know. Everybody thinks pancakes, but you can do so much more. The thing about maple syrup is that it's sweet, but it's also woodsy. It's got kind of a woodsy flavor to it, and it's not super sweet, and it's really good for you. There are more antioxidants in maple syrup than there are in Brussels sprouts.
We're showing the bottle here. What do you like for maple syrup? What type of it is it?
Well, okay, now this is an amber syrup. You can also get a really dark syrup. The dark syrup has a stronger maple flavor. It's better for baking and things. This I'm just going to use to season the cauliflower. And you have a recipe for this that's being put up online. But it's a spicy, sweet cauliflower. Now, cauliflower is just a little bit bitter. And we're going to add a little bit. This is a za'atar seasoning, which is a Middle Eastern seasoning. And just a little bit of...
And it's called za'atar.
It's Z-A-A-T-A-R. You can find it at Penzi's and some of the spice shops. I'm working that in. I'm going to put a squeeze of lime over this.
And what's the lime do?
That adds a little bit of sour. Because we're making this sweet, sour, and hot. Okay? So this adds just enough of the sour. And then we're going to work in just a little bit of maple syrup, not a whole lot. And that's going to sort of, what happens when you add sweet, hot, or salty is the flavors amplify each other. So by adding the sweet, that's going to amplify both the hot and the sour.
So they bring out the best.
They bring out the best
flavoring,
in each other.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, I always think of sort of when you're designing a living room or something, you're using contrasting colors.
Yeah.
You want to use contrasting flavors when you're cooking. And that kind of ramps things up. So
nice.
What we're going to do is toss in a few dried cranberries just to give it some color because it's kind of dull looking. And a few cashews for crunch. You could use any kind of nuts or any
whatever
kind of dried
fruit. Whatever
your favorite
is, it works.
That's exactly right. And then we're going to serve this. This is a dark bread that I've just spread with a little bit of chèvre. And so we're just going to serve this with the chèvre and drizzle again the whole thing with just a wee bit of maple syrup, including the dark bread, okay? And what you have then is something that's so easy and light. You could serve this for brunch. You could serve it for lunch.
This would be a nice meatless entree, actually.
It would. That's so hearty and nice there. Totally.
I love it. I love how the spices, they like each other.
It smells good, right?
Which is good. It smells wonderful.
Yeah.
Beth,
good.
As always, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Check out Beth's yummy recipe at care11.com. Look under the 4 p.m. show page. Well,